Hey guys, it's again time for a cracking beer review. We have this one from Brewery Werbroek. They are from Roesbrugge. I don't know where Roesbrugge is in Belgium, but I think it's Belgium, it's not France. You can see here the Belgian flag, so I think it's Wallonie. So it's the double brown. I had the triple blonde.
Oh no.
That was not my thing. I gotta tell you, I didn't like it. And my buddy Marx can tell me, do review this one, and he got me half a euro off of the price. And I said to him, okay, I will review it. So here it is, the double brown. They also got a triple amber one. I don't know about that one. I'm gonna try it later, but it's all about this one. That seems to be the best. So this double brown, we're gonna taste it now. It comes in at 8% ABV, guys. So keep watching, and I hope this is a good beer. I got my opener this time with me. So, okay, the label looks really nice with the falcon on there. Oh. Hey guys, we had some technical difficulties. The flickering was steady again. It was really going on again on the screen. And I don't like it when the image isn't good. So I got to restart it. That's why there is a gap between the videos, like you can see.
Oh no.
But it's all about the double. And I got my opener, like I told you guys. So, here we go. We're gonna try it. The double brown.
Oh yeah.
From this brewery. What's it called again? Brewery Werbroek. Okay. And it's all for my buddy Marksken from the Kuttigheimhoeve in Sint-Amans. Okay. He told me this is the best one. The label is always looking nice. And here you can see some tasting notes, like it's complex or it's mild or it's gonna be sweet and things. So there is something on this bottle. That's a good start, of course. Here is the beer. It has a red shine to it, so maybe some dry fruits in there. Most of the time there are dry fruits in there, like you have seen my videos, and when there is a red shine to it, there must be some cherries notes or some dry fruits in there to give it that red shine, of course. And here we go. Cheers, guys. First on the nose. Not that much on the nose, a little bit malty. It feels rather complex. I don't think it is a thick one, a creamy one. I don't think so. So we're just gonna try it. If it is a bad one, I'm gonna tell you guys. If it is an awesome one, I'm gonna tell you also. So we're gonna try it. Cheers, guys. Cheers, Marskin. Drinks really smooth, yeah. There is no problem with that part. Red berries. I do get red berries.
Oh yeah.
I do get the spices like I got in the first one. The triple blonde I tried before.
Uh-oh.
I did get a rather huge amount of spices in that one. That's why I told you I didn't like it, to be honest. It got like, for me it was like a 6 out of 10. This one is better. This one gets a 7 out of 10 for me. It feels rather complex. You get your dry fruits, your malty notes, your wheats, your grains, your malts, your...
3, 2, 1.
Licorice. Yes. It has that roasted feel to it. This must be indeed the best one of the three. Because they have three of them. And I think this one is the best one of the three they have. So that's a good start. When it's the best one of the three, for sure. You know it already. Like, I will try the triple amber again. That was the one with 9.5% ABV. I think that one is the strongest one in ABV also. So, but I like this one. It is rather complex, like I told you. And it has that spicy thing all over it. But it goes really well with the double style beer. The spices. Not with the blonde. I'm not really a fan of blonde beers like triples with too many spices in that. In those, and I did get it, like, there were rather some spices in there. So, okay, I'm gonna round it up. It is a 7 out of 10 for me, guys. So don't forget, a beer day gives it away. Cheers, guys.